tell me a little bit about your fight to protect the life of the unborn and the unborn child. I mean, that's a big issue in evangelical communities, is that we want to protect life.
It's a big issue for me, and I tell people that really it's all about when life begins. You know, I'm a physician. One of the things that I would do in my job is to go into the pediatric nursery, and I would examine babies that are 1 pound babies, looking in their eye to try to make sure that they didn't suffer from blindness from being born prematurely. And the interesting thing is, when you're in the neonatal nursery and you got a 1 pound baby, everybody acknowledges that that baby has rights. The Bill of Rights applies to that baby, and nobody can hurt that baby. It's a 1 pound baby. But a week before, even a full-term 7 pound baby has no rights, according to the way people are looking at it. And I think that's a big mistake. So I've introduced legislation called the Life at Conception Act to define when life begins at conception. I've also probably am co-sponsored a 20-some-odd pro-life bills. I have 100% voting record for pro-life. But I also have taken the time to go to the March for Life. And they're having, I think when I was there, I was the only senator that showed up for the March for Life. And so I do think it's important, because I think, and I'll often say in my speeches, that I don't think a civilization can long endure that doesn't respect the rights of the unborn.